हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल लर्न टू प्रोग्राम 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड वी विल राइट ए प्रोग्राम टू इंटरफेस द एलईडी विद द 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर। फॉर दिस वी नीड टू सॉफ्टवेयर्स। फर्स्ट वन इज द कील माइक्रो वर्जन 5। सो वी विल गो टू द गूगल एंड विल राइट हेयर कील माइक्रो वर्जन। And after that, by clicking this, we will go to the site www.keel and go to the download tab. Here we will find these two files. So after this, we will go to the product downloads. Here we will find these four files. We will select the C51 file and after that we will go to the this executable file. By clicking this and we will download it to some folder. We can download it in C drive, D drive. Here we will create a new folder by naming setup key, or you can name anyone. After that you will save it here, and after downloading we will install it and it will be look like this. Here we can see it, Keel Micro Vision 5. So we click it so here we will firstly go to the project tab and we'll close all the projects and go to the again project tab and we'll select the new Micro Vision project. We will create one folder, maybe it on the desktop. Here I am taking the desktop and we'll write here segment. And in this, again in this folder I am taking name as segment and extension is .uv project. Here it is demanding the microcontroller name, so here we will select AT89C51. This is, and this is the description of this microcontroller, that it has 24 megahertz CMOS controller with 32 IO lines and all the other specification of this microcontroller. After that we will select OK and it is asking for the copy startup.a51 to project folder and add file to the project. We will select no. After that we will go to the file tab and select the new file. We will name it as segment. It is save it in the same folder which we have taken it in the desktop, naming segment. In the segment folder we are saving the file segment and the now extension is .c. We will go to the file new and go for it save as, and we'll write here segment.c. Now I have written the code in the notepad. I will also give it to you in the description. Now copy it and paste in this editor. Now again save it and double click this source group and select the file segment.c, add it. Now you can see this file here. By closing this window, pop-up window, and now you can see the segment file is visible here. Now we will go to the now we will double click this. And go to the option for target. In this we can see here frequency shown 24.0, so you will select it as 11.0592, and tick it. This also use on chip ROM. And now after that, this target tab, we go to the output tab. Here we will select the create hex file. You have to tick it, and after that, okay. Now again save it and go to this project tab and say build project. It will check. It is saying that there is some error. So we will check what is the error. Here is the error is that this seg is not defined, because this seg we defined is in small letters and it is in the capital letters. So as C language is case sensitive language, so we will write it in small, and also this X is also in capital, so we will also correct it by writing in lower case. So again save it and try to rebuild. Here we have these three icons. One is for the translate, second is for build, third is for rebuild, and fourth is the batch build. So we will go to the rebuild, and now here we can see that there is no error. It is showing zero errors and zero warnings. So now we try to debug it. We will go to the debugging and start stop debugging. It is now saying that running with code size limit 2k. As we have the free version, so we have the code size limit of 2k. If we have some paid version, so it can be the greater than 2k size, but our code is smaller than this, so it is suitable for it. So now the code is debugging. We can also see the output in the peripherals. We will select the IO ports here. As in the code we are selecting port P1, so here we will select the port P1. So in this now debugging step by step, we can see we will find the changed value here, which is shown in the blue color. So let's start. We will press it and can see that our code value is now 0. Now as we have taken an array of these values C0, F9, A4, B0, 99, it will be given to the port P1, and accordingly our 7 segment LCD will work. So let's see. Now you can see after one step debugging, we can see this is now C0, which is our first value of this array. Again we can see the value has changed to the F9, which is the second one, and again we can see this value is changed to the A4. So likewise our program is working. So now we will try to embed it into the microcontroller hardware simulation. So for that we need the second software, which is Proteus. This is the Proteus. I have downloaded it, so I will share the link of this also to you. So let's start with it. You can see this window will pop up. As you will click this, you will go to the new project. Give some name it to the, so I am taking it as segment as we have taken it in skill software also segment. So I am writing here segment dot pd sprj. So we will go to the next. Here it is asking for the do not create a schematic or create a schematic from the selected template. So we have requirement of schematic, so we take it as default and go to the next tab. Here it is asking for do not create a PCB layout or create a PCB layout. We have no any requirement of PCB layout for this, so we are taking it as do not create a PCB layout and we will go to the next. Here it is asking for no firmware project or create firmware project. Our project is a firmware project, so we can take it or we can go for the no firmware project. So here we are taking the no firmware project and let's see what it will show. This window will appear to you. So we will select a device from this pick devices. Window will appear here and we will write here AT89C51 controller. AT89C51 controller. Where it is? It is here. So we select it. We will say OK. After that, again, we will go for the 7 segment LED. So we will write the 7 segment. So here we can see different type of LEDs. We will go for the red 7 segment common anode LED and select OK. Now we will take this controller and put it here. We will take this 7 segment and put it here and we'll make connections. So in this way we can connect the pins. Likewise, this third pin is connected with the and again we will connect all the pins. This fourth will connect it to the this fourth and this fifth. To this fifth. And this seventh. In this way. Okay. Now we have the requirement of the power. So we will go to this point. Here we can see the terminals. We will take the input terminal and put it here. Now we will connect it to our 7 segment like this. After doing this, we will go to the microcontroller. We will click double on this and this window will pop up. Here we will set the frequency same as done in the MicroVision software 11.059 and we'll give the hex file path here by browsing it, these program files. We will go to the desktop here in this segment file, objects file, we can see this hex file. So we will select it and open it in this and go to OK. Now all things are okay and we can run it. So by for simulation we click this play button.